guys. My name is Bethany Herway and I'm the Glamorous Housewife. Today I'm really excited because I am starting a new series. I'm calling it Making It Modern because I'm taking some of the recipes from my old recipe books from the 1940s, 50s, and 60s and reviewing them, seeing, you know, what kind of food they used to make, and then creating a modern recipe using vintage techniques. That's coming up next here on The Glamorous Housewife. So today we are going to be making a meat sauce that originally went on top a bed of noodles. And I know meat sauce and noodles, it's been done a million times, but the reason this piqued my interest is because it used evaporated milk. Now, I personally have never used evaporated milk, not even once, and you know, I thought they were talking about sweetened condensed milk, and I thought it was pretty much the most disgusting thing I'd ever heard of. So I started to do some research, and it turns out, obviously, evaporated milk is not sweetened condensed milk. Evaporated milk is essentially a shelf-stable milk that has some of the water taken out of it. So it's kind of like, you know, a condensed milk, but not, like I said, a sweetened condensed milk. Now, it turns out that evaporated milk is a great substitution for heavy cream when you want to add a bit of milky creaminess to your sauce, but without all of the fat and calories. So I'm going to show you right now how I did this recipe and how I changed it up. The first thing that the recipe calls for is 3 ounces of cream cheese. Now, cream cheese is delicious, I love it, but it's high in fat and it's definitely high in calories. Now, it's only 3 ounces, so if you want to go with regular cream cheese, go right ahead, be my guest. But I decided to make it a little bit healthier by using Neufchâtel cheese. So Neufchâtel is a cheese that is processed in such a way that it doesn't have nearly the fat and calories of regular cream cheese, but it tastes exactly the same. Like, I did a taste test with my husband and neither of us could tell which one was the cream cheese and which one was the Neufchâtel. So to that, we are going to add the aforementioned milk. Now, it called for 1/2 cup. This is slightly more than 1/2 cup because that's how big this you know, can is. This is 5 fluid ounces. I just didn't feel like throwing the little bit that was left away. Okay, that looks pretty good. To this, we're gonna add 2 tablespoons of lemon juice and 1 teaspoon of Worcestershire sauce. I happen to love Worcestershire sauce. I think it definitely gives a little bit of smokiness, definitely savory or umami flavor. It adds some tang, and it just so happens to be a very popular ingredient in the 1950s and 1960s. I know my mother cooks it all the time because most of her recipes come from this era. Okay, so I'm gonna show you right now. This is what it looks like. It's not the prettiest. And here's the kind of texture. The cream cheese is mostly, or the Neufchâtel is mostly incorporated, and I'm just gonna add a little bit of salt. Now, in the original recipe, it called for just some boiled noodles. And again, that is perfectly acceptable, and if I was making this for my family, I'd probably do like 1/2 of this casserole with boiled noodles for my kids, and the other half with what I'm gonna show you now. This is spaghetti squash. Here it is, whole, and I love it. I'm obsessed with it. I've been eating it almost every day for breakfast. I know that sounds weird. So what you do, I have tried it a myriad of ways. I cut it, scooped out the seeds, and then put it in the microwave for, I started it off at 10 minutes and it wasn't ready, so I added another 8 minutes to it. Now, 18 minutes is kind of a long time, but you can get the rest of this dish cooking while the spaghetti squash is cooking in the microwave. So once it's soft, you can see it starts to fall apart. And I just take a fork, and you can see it just falls apart just like spaghetti noodles. And I'm putting it right into the sauce. Okay, that's one half. It's not gonna be enough, so I use both halves of the spaghetti squash. It's funny, when I was working on this recipe, I went ahead and cooked the whole thing from start to finish using exactly the ingredients that it called for. And I was really surprised at how delicious it ended up being. I thought it would be a lot blander and frankly not very tasty, but we did a taste test with, I also did a version of this myself and had some people over, and you know, we each tasted each one, and it turns out each person liked both. The original is sweeter, but they like the tanginess and the addition of spaghetti squash in my version. Okay, so I'm mixing the spaghetti squash around, and that's what it looks like. And I'm gonna set this to the side, and we are now going to cook the meat sauce.
Start by warming a pan over medium heat. Add some olive oil and then a small chopped onion and an orange pepper. Stir to combine and then cook for about 5 minutes until softened. Now push the veggies to the side to make room for the meat. Carefully crumble the beef into the pan, then let it cook through, stirring a few times. When the meat is done, you're going to want to pour off the fat that's collected at the bottom of the pan till you only have about 2 tablespoons left. Next, you're going to make some room in the pan for 1 can of tomato paste. Let this cook for a minute or two to get rid of the tinny flavor, and then add 1 8-ounce can of tomato sauce. If the mixture is too thick, you can add a little bit of water. Let this cook for about 5 to 10 minutes and then take it off of the heat.
So now we have finished our bottom mixture, which is the creamy sauce with the spaghetti squash. You can also use noodles. And we've got the meat sauce, which we just finished cooking. So I decided to use this pan mainly because it looks really pretty, but you can use any baking dish you want. And just pour the kind of cream mixture, whether it be spaghetti squash or noodles. And that's creating the bottom layer. I'm just using my fork, or if you're using a spoon or spatula, to evenly spread it around. And then I like to make it look sort of like a pie. So I'm forming the edge, making the bottom flat, just because I think it looks prettier. And the kids, who there's no way they are going to be eating the spaghetti squash, but if I could get them to do it, it would be because it looks more like a pie. Okay, there we go. And then we just fill it in with the meat sauce. Now I used beef because I'm terribly bored of turkey, but you could easily use turkey here. You could grind up some chicken, or if you're vegetarian, I really like the fake beef Morningstar crumbles, I think is what they call it. This would be excellent here as well. And voila, all you have to do now is put it into your oven at 375 degrees for about 8 to 10 minutes. Once you've cooked your casserole for 8 to 10 minutes, pull it on out, and you're gonna let it cool just for, you know, a few more minutes while you're finished setting the table. And I like to present it with just a little bit of basil, a little fresh basil. It's hot, so look, voila, doesn't it look beautiful? Much prettier than that curly parsley that they love to use in the 1950s. So I like to serve this with, you know, with a side of simple green salad with a little bit of vinaigrette. My kids love the ranch. A nice glass of wine, and you have a beautiful, easy family dinner. So that's it for this version of Making It Modern with the Glamorous Housewife. I will see you ladies here next week. And remember, if you love my videos, you can also see a bonus video every Friday if you sign up to my newsletter. They're the only ones who get the links. Thanks, ladies. Bye.